our Savior is painting a picture of the great high feast that is prepared for all of us. This is the greatest miracle. This is a miracle that lasts more than just a few hours with a full belly. This is a miracle that has lasted 2,000 years and will continue to survive until he comes again as he feeds us with his very body and blood given and shed for you who are God. What is our greatest hunger? To know that we're forgiven. To know that God has not abandoned us. To be certain that God will never forsake us. Our greatest hunger isn't bread and fish. It's for the certainty of forgiveness. And that's exactly what God does for us. He feeds us with his body and blood. He knows what our real food is. He doesn't give us just a reminder of what he did for us on Calvary. It's not enough just to give us a meal that represents this feast. Christ gives us the real food. He said, take, eat. This is my body. This is my blood. This is food that we cannot buy on our own, that we cannot do on our own, that we can't satisfy our own desires. Isaiah wrote it so beautifully when he said, he who has no money, come and eat. God does not expect us to feed ourselves. We can't satisfy our own need for forgiveness and redemption and life. So it is, he gives us his body and blood to drink because he is the Redeemer. He is the one who gives us his whole soul and body, not just in the spiritual form, but in the very flesh and blood, so that we take it into us. We have this intimate connection with God our Father. Although he himself is without sin, he takes our sin on the cross, and it feeds us with the certainty that our sins, our hunger, has been satisfied. He knows that we need more than just to be forgiven. We also need to be renewed. And in this meal, our faith is strengthened. In this meal, we are able to go forth in a world that continues to befuddle us and blast us. His love is so great that his own compassion, Jesus, comes to us. Come, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. Come, no money. Come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money, without price. That's what his invitation is to us, to come to this table. His love and compassion extends because he knows our greatest need. And our hunger is in direct proportion to our need. And I can only speak for myself, but I've been your pastor for a number of years. I know my sins are great. And because of that, I know your sins are great. And we need to come to this table and be fed. We need to come as the bride of Christ, as he gives us his food, the best he ever had. His very body and blood, not only a representation, but a very real meal, so that we will be satisfied. His compassion satisfies not our stomachs, but our hearts. Because of the value of this meal increases with the proportion of need, he knows that when we come to the table, this will be the greatest meal we've ever had. Amen. May the peace which passes all human understanding keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Let us together make confession of our Christian faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us then and for our salvation
rejoicing that you feed us the meal that provides all that we need, the true comfort food for our souls, your very body and blood, for the forgiveness of sins, for the strengthening of faith, and the assurance of life everlasting. We pray also for those who are continuing to be hungry in their souls. Move us to share this gospel, that they too may know that there is a place where they come to eat without cost, to drink without fee, that they can be healed of all their diseases of the body and soul. We ask you, Lord, to bless those who are sick and hospitalized, those who are alone. Remind them of your presence. Even in the midst of our struggles and challenges, you are there with us. We pray for those who are suffering from loved ones because of service in the armed forces. We ask you to protect them and keep them safe. Be with their families that they may rejoice in the service of their loved ones and be reunited according to your good and gracious will. We pray all these things through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives, reigns, and with you now and forever. The Lord be with you. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way, also he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
hereditary gift, and we implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us to the same in faith toward you and in perfect love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace.